There are three ways to add CSS to an HTML document. We can either embed the style sheet in the head of the document using the style element, or specify the style directly in a start tag using the style attribute, or link to an external style sheet. Let's create a basic HTML document. The style element is a container for style sheet rules and should have its type attribute set to text CSS. Inside the element, we can type any CSS we want. For example, we can add a rule to color all paragraphs elements in the document using the color property. We'll give it a red color using hexadecimal notation. Now, if we refresh, we'll see that the text inside of the paragraph becomes red. If we look at the page in a browser, we can see exactly how the page will look. For cases where we want to assign styling to an individual element, we can use the style attribute to set an inline style. This attribute can be applied to all HTML tags. It uses double quotation marks instead of curly brackets around the declaration, and we don't have to specify a selector since it automatically applies to a current element. Next, we have external style sheets. To use one, we first need to create a new text document and save it with a CSS extension. We'll add a rule to it, and then we'll just need to link it to our HTML document. This can be done in CSS using the @import function. It must be placed before all other rules for it to work. A more common way of including style sheets is using the link element. We set its relationship attribute to style sheet, the meta type to text CSS, and finally specify the location of the style sheet. Using external style sheets is often the most useful approach, since it completely separates CSS from the HTML document. It allows us to quickly create a consistent look for an entire website, and to change its appearance just by editing a single CSS document. Lastly, we can create comments in CSS using the C-style notation. A comment will be ignored by browsers, and it can be several lines long.